Well, let's turn now to an alarming shortage of vital medication on our pharmacy shelves. So key ADHD, antidepressants, asthma and blood pressure medications running dangerously low.
And today's medical expert, Dr. Nick Coatsworth, joins us from Canberra. Good morning, Dr. Coatsworth. These medications are widely used, heavily depended on. How have we got to a situation where we've got a shortage?
Charles, they are widely used and there's a lot of them on that list, which is what makes this unusual. From time to time, we do get medication shortages. In fact, we were short of penicillin about 4 years ago. Beg your pardon, might need a bit of penicillin. We were short of penicillin 4 years ago and you know, that was because of supply chain shortages out of China. Now, this could be the same sort of issue. I suspect that it is a manufacturing issue, but the difference is how many that we're short of, and it just exemplifies that we have to diversify our supply sources for our medical products. They cannot just come from one or two countries. And sometimes, Ali, one or two factories.
Yeah, and then you've got the issue then too, because people hear that there's a shortage and people go out and they panic buy. Yeah. So if you've got, you know, say a kid with asthma, you want to make sure you've got medications at home, but that adds to the problem, of course. Hey, look, the Chief Health Medical Officer believes that we've passed the peak of this winter COVID wave. Do you agree? And, you know, are we going to see another one anytime soon?
Well, look, Paul is the authority on this, so I definitely agree. But there are some other signs, of course, that is the case. The number of hospitalisations peaked last week and is trending down, and I think that's an excellent sign. Influenza peaked probably about a month ago. So that pressure, that sustained pressure on the health system is highly likely to reduce in the coming weeks, which is just such good news for our healthcare workers and even better news for the Australian community.
Good news, but also vital news. We're hearing about GPs warning that bulk billing is on the verge of collapse. We've got, you know, wait times of weeks and potentially months to get in for just consultations. And some practices warning patients they just can't continue consultations. Will this be alleviated by those two waves ending, or is this a problem that we have to deal with on a much bigger scale?
Charles, these are problems that have been exposed by COVID-19 rather than caused by COVID-19. And were we to ignore these signs into the future, if we had another significant outbreak of an infectious disease or other strains on our healthcare system, we'll find ourselves in the same sort of situation. It is hard for bulk billing GPs. The rebate hasn't moved in years. And of course, as we discussed last week on the show, there's fewer and fewer graduates going to general practice. So we do need medium to long-term solutions. We need a strategic view rather than a short-term view. Yes, you know, control COVID, but it's controlling itself within the community. The wave's on the way down. Let's start fixing the health system. And of course, a lot of us are targeting our minds towards that.
And Nick, I just want to talk to you too, this worrying development in the area of Alzheimer's, that key research, which underpins our understanding of the disease, is fraudulent.
Well, that has been reported in the past few weeks, Ali, and of course, that just reminds us. I mean, the background to the story was that some original papers that were done, people were concerned that the photographs that proved the idea that Alzheimer's was caused by a particular protein could have been doctored way back in about 2006, I think it was. This just proves that at this time where there's so much new science coming through, that as scientists, we have to be conservative, we have to be sceptical, but we also have to replicate the studies. And if we stick to the scientific method, then these sort of problems tend not to happen, whether it's Alzheimer's, COVID, or any other sort of disease.
So is this perhaps why, I mean, we haven't seen any great developments in this area, right, in the last decade or so. Is this in any way linked to this fraudulent research?
Well, I'd hasten to add that there are allegations of fraud at this stage. That's important to say. But it is entirely possible. I mean, if you point the direction and sort of hundreds of millions, if not billions of dollars worth of research in one direction and you don't get any result, then it could be that you were led down the wrong path to start with. So I think it's an important thing for people with dementia and the scientific community looking at it to keep an eye on. And it's important messages for the scientific community about the pitfalls of research.
Yeah, because it is, of course, a horrible disease that impacts so many. Nick, always good to talk to you this morning.
Thank you both.